Hello everyone, I am Taureor and welcome back to Let's Play The Witcher 3 on Deathmatch difficulty. Right, we accepted the quest from this guy. I guess I could select it as my current one. Which was that? This one? No. Oh, those are the completed ones. Yeah, let's forget that. Precious cargo. I think that's this one. Find a little box. Sure. Let's go and find where the cart went off the road. Gee, do I really need my witcher senses for that? There's clearly tracks here.
Cart tracks. Rode off into the swamp.
Yeah, it did. Get me Quen. On this difficulty, Quen seems to be a must. Also, let's not forget those clouds of swamp gas. It is a beehive, but I did already say what I think about people burning bees, even in game. I mean, it's acceptable in game, but I really wish they did it differently, like made you put Quen up to loot it or something. Okay.
An arrow. Didn't mention this.
So they say something about devouring.
Look around.
Stumble towards dust. Still no silver. Still no silver. Buy some grass. Fifth essence. Diamond dust. That's expensive.
Carts riddled with arrows.
And that carts riddled with arrows. Alchemist's powder. Nothing too fancy. Yeah, there's a body here. Hello.
Square in the neck. Good shot. Either the merchant's got serious memory problems, or he's lying.
I wonder which it is. Actually, I don't. Pretty obvious. And here is a drowner. Next to a blow-upable barrel. Hello. Ah, he ran away. Damn it. Well, we did have a reasonable chance of killing him with that barrel. Come on, come on. Problem with drowners is, if you fight them in a wet surface like this, they can jump out and walk at you. Oops. Let's steer clear of the swamp gas. They can actually be used in combat if you ignite it. Okay, the drowner's dead. Can I search this body? Oh, did you aggro me as well? Apparently. Let's clean up then. Hello. Oops. Right. I guess I got him against the tree, so I'll just keep whacking. Monster heart. Can I maybe loot this body here? Nope. Okay, let's go back to the quest area. And there's something here. Locked strongbox.
Must be that box he mentioned. Splattered with blood. Human blood.
Okay, so he killed this guy that looks like a merchant to steal stuff from him, apparently. That means we don't like that guy. And we're probably going to kill him. Oh, if you haven't seen, this is what happens with the swamp gas. Cool, huh? Difficult to use tactically, but can be useful. Fool's parsley. Hey, hello, liar person.
Oh, and you find the box?
Found it here. Should I give it to him? Nah.
Yeah, found your priceless chest. And someone who looks an awful lot like a cart driver, with an arrow through his neck. No dryads in these swamps, and never known a drowner or a water hack to use a bow. So lacking any other suspects, I'm guessing.
Watch out! Behind you!
There's nothing behind me. I'm a witcher, I'd have heard it. Just like I can hear your heart, which is pounding, like a liar's. Best hope you're a better rider than you are a liar.
Yay, horse race. Come on, Roach. Roach? Hello? Here's Roach. Come on. Oh, crap. Why'd you hide that sword? I need to kill this person. Good. Oh, gotta he's not dead. Here. Oh, I did kill him.
Wake up. See? Nope. Can't run from the truth. Not even on horseback. Now, who are you, and why'd you attack that cart?
Private First Class John Gamer. Temerian 6th Division, 2nd Regiment. Disbanded, but still active. Underground, in the woods. That was a medical transport. I'd be damned if it reached the Black Ones. And the medicine. Our lads could use it, too. We've many ill among us. You let me go, and they might live and fight once more for a free North.
Do we really care? Taking you to the North Guardian, you're free to go, medicine stays with me, or I let him go. Do I let him go? Well, let's think about it. If I take him to the North Guardian, will I gain anything? Also, what is floating in the background? What is this? Looks really weird. Should I kill him? Well, he did murder a merchant. He did murder a merchant. He didn't try to kill me. I could take some medicine for myself. I guess the Nilfgaardians won't like me more for this, but the Temerians could, so let's let him go.
Fine. Go. And may you and your soldier buddies hiding in the bushes be victorious in your struggle against Nilfgaard.
You've a vile sense of humor. But you're a decent man. Here, the gold I promised. Use it well. Drink to the silver lilies and to Foltest's memory.
You do realize you're already lost, right? There's no winning this. At least, not for you. Maybe for Radovid. Alright, I feel I shouldn't lecture him. I know way too much about the game's world to be, you know, to have the right to lecture him. Oh, that's a herbalist. But there's a lot to discover in the area first. Let's go and discover it, as it should be. Actually, I was supposed to change weapons. Let's change weapons. A critical hit increase was serving me quite well. We're quenned up. We're relatively safe from anything. Oh, deserters! Well, that was quick. Actually, against deserters, the armor-piercing one might be better. Although they don't really have armor. Let's change the weapon and see if it works better. Come on, Mr. Deserter.
Not too late to surrender.
Yeah, it does work better. Sorry. Oh right, I forgot the axeman. How can they block so well? But we do have axe against such people. Yeah, it does work better against humans, so I should be using this one. Dumplings, yay. Pierogi. Some silver, that can be useful. Any gambeson, I don't usually make those normal, you know, crafted items. Oh, you killed someone. You bastards. Oh, there's a corpse I didn't loot. Dumplings! Yay! Those were dumpling bandits. And there's someone hostile around here. A wolf. And now against armor, the other swords better, because they don't really have armor, I think. but they can be critically hit. Did you guys not just kill all those rabbits? That's not how wolves behave. They would have killed one and then eaten it and then killed another. More or less. Not exactly, but... Well, since you already did, might as well... Those are murderous. I might as well go around and gather some stuff from them. Oh! Is that a bear? No, that's something else. Oh, another one. Oh, and goodbye. Lone wolves are not really a danger to us. We are the wolf, after all. The white one. And... Goddammit, where's that corpse? Here it is. Lots of meat. Will be useful since we're eating all the time. Yeah, the gourmet trait is actually quite valuable and useful. Why do you keep going around killing all those bloody rabbits? Makes no sense for those wolves. No, you're alive at least. Oh, another empty trunk with money. Good thing I didn't fast travel. A lot. Right, we have gathered everything in the vicinity. There's still something over this way. Yeah, I'm going to explore this whole region before I move on. And then we can handle the contracts that we have. It's going up, we're going into the swamp. That can be pretty dangerous. Guarded treasure. Is it though? Alright. Where's your guard? No guard. I'll walk around, maybe I'll kill something. Nope, no guard. Let's at least burn it up a bit. Alright, what else do we have to explore in the area? We need to visit the herbalist. Okay, I guess I can take care of this later on. I wonder where's the key to that chest near the mill? Alright, let's go this way. We need to visit the herbalist after all. Oh, did the wolves respawn? No, that's a warg. Oh crap, I forgot to clear out. This can be dangerous if I don't kill the wolf quickly. But I did kill the wolf quickly, so it is no longer really that dangerous. Yeah, I have some fire damage. Yeah, that was quick. Right, do you have something better than dog tallow? No. Actually, dog tallow is useful. So is meat. At least for us. I'm living off chicken sandwiches now. That's not bad. Actually, I would love to have a chicken sandwich right now. Well, I should probably... Oh, I can hear bees again. Right, those are ghouls. We need to change swords, and it would be wise to apply oil. Come on, ghouls. Yeah, the oil increases damage quite significantly. Wish I had more silver, I could have made the better sword. That would have, you know, increased the damage even further. Oops, we're out of Quen. Those are just level 2 ghouls. We should be relatively safe unless we do something stupid. Get between two ghouls. Right now. Nope, this one's almost dead, so yeah, as soon as he's dead, we're fine. Right. That wasn't that difficult. Yeah, that's what should have happened at the last site we cleared of ghouls. People moving in. Do I get anything for that? Do I? Yay, level 2! Let's take advantage of that immediately. Hello, steel sword. Do you have any interesting runes to put in it? Chance to stun, chance to stagger, chance to cause burning, chance to freeze. sign intensity. Actually, chance to freeze seems nice. Let's put the chance to freeze rune in there. Should I? Or should I wait for a bigger rune? That's just a lesser one. We can actually remove upgrades. So let's not skimp on this. Okay, our steel weapon is now much better. Okay then. Talk to boy. Most desire. And the merchant.
Greetings.
Would you like to play Gwent? No, you wouldn't. Let's see what he has.
Look at your stock.
He has alchemical stuff. Do you want to buy a gold ring? You do, but for very, very little. 27 for the white bear hide and 30 for the ring. That's not satisfactory. I wonder what the guy that we saved will pay. Although I could sell you monster blood or ghoul blood. Though the alchemist might pay for it as well. He would pay 5. I'll think about
farewell.
It. Not alchemist, herbalist. Okay, let's loot the guys. The ghouls that we killed. Here's one. Monster's ear. Okay, and the herbalist should live close by here. Alright. Maybe we'll encounter something to kill on the way. I need better armor. I need to buy that Temerian armor from the merchant in the village. Oh, wolves are killing people. And the guards do nothing. We, Geralt, the savior of the people. And our amazing new steel sword that deals double the damage that our previous one did. Okay, stop running away, what's that? Can't search the corpse for some reason. No, just a rabbit. The wolf was killing rabbits. Well, yeah, that is not funny. Okay, something went wrong, I can't loot anything. Did the game freeze on me? Okay, something crapped out. I cannot loot anything. Oh, now I can. What was that? Okay, there's a lot of interesting ingredients here. Let's do this sweepy looty thing. That's pretty much what I used to do in Morrowind. You know, when you first arrive in the first little town, and you go to every house and steal all the buckets. And all the cups from the cupboards and all that, and then you go to the one merchant in town and sell it all, and then you steal it again from his cellar. Yeah, that's how I used to play Morrowind. Seems silly, but it was actually very, very enjoyable. Okay, let's take all these ingredients. They might come in handy later. Anything else here? Oh, wine stone. Yeah, let's steal everything. As we usually do. Okay, to the hut. Hello, Tamira.
Yes.
Yeah, in a minute. Got any herbs?
Got any herbs you're willing to sell?
I'm sure I can find something.
What do you have? She does have some formulas, but it's actually pretty common to find formulas in various places. How much will you pay for the ghoul blood? Oh, you will pay more. Will you buy the ring? You will for 41, which is not a very good price. But I will sell you some ghoul's blood. I don't need all of it. Actually, I will sell you as much as you can buy. I do have a lot of ghoul blood. You can probably dismantle it for something useful. Actually, while we're here, I might use her to buy some ingredients necessary for alchemy. And 3 arenaria. Let's make it immediately. This is quite convenient that you can flip between those, options so easily. Water essence and dwarven spirit. Do you have those? Is it expensive? It is expensive. I'm not going to buy that. What else? Grape shot. We need salt, pepper, and calcium equum. We can do that, yeah. Let's buy that. I did see calcium. Here it is. 40. 40 is not that much. And salt, pepper. Yeah, I don't really use bombs, but they are useful for, you know, for destroying monsters' nests. Let's see, do we have any special monster decoctions? Relievers decoction. Interesting, but we don't have mutagens yet. Okay, we're pretty much done with the crafting. Let's go to the shop screen again. Do you want to buy some, I don't know, do you want to buy some rib leaf? No. But you do want to buy some more ghoul blood. An algal bone marrow. Where did I kill an algal? Oh, maybe they were the things that I found it in, what's the word? I found those in the ghoul nests, that's where. Wine stone. I guess I can sell you maybe 3 more ghoul blood. I'm going to kill many ghouls in this game. You want a drowner brain or two? Lots of drowners as well. Anything else? Oh, do we have like monster blood or monster heart or something? Yeah, that'll have to do. I don't want to get rid of all the things that I need. That I might need later. Okay. That will be it for her. And did I already say that knowing many formulas is important? But right now I need the money quite a lot, so let's not waste it. What's your story?
Tell me something about yourself. What's your story?
A sad one. Do you know the Temple of Melitele in Alanda?
Do I know it? Can't remember how many times I've been there, how many times Mother Nenica stitched me up.
We must have missed each other. I started to become a healer under Mother Nenica. I was but 18 when they took me in. An age at which teachings interest one far less than love. There was a boy, Goslath. He'd bare his chest to work. The novices couldn't keep their eyes off him, tripped over their own feet, dropped things. I left the temple for him. We passed a lovely summer together, and then he left. Nenike refused to take me back. My parents uttered not a word. Gave me a travel cloak and a small coin pouch. I struggled long to find a place where I'd feel safe, needed, until I finally arrived here. End of story.
Well, did the griffin injure the woman? What woman? Oh, right, I remember. There's a woman here.
Griffin do that to her?
Talina. Yes. Attacked her at night. She was walking in the woods.
At night? Through the woods? In wartime?
Meeting a boy. The young, you know, do foolish things for love. Wounds are healing, but she will die. Blood's pooling in her skull. Nothing my bruise can do to help.
I'll kill the griffin, no more victims. I could try to help her.
Could try to help her with one of my potions. Swallow can heal internal hemorrhages.
But?
Witcher's potions aren't for humans.
She'll die as it is.
Yes. A peaceful death soothed by your concoctions. If I give her swallow and something goes wrong, the whole village will hear her screams.
I understand. Do as you will.
Yeah,
farewell. Yeah.
Pain is better than death if there is a chance for life.
Yes.
Get a potion.
Got a potion for Lena. Swallow.
First sign of spring. Symbol of rebirth. Fitting as names go.
We'll see. Like I said, could harm her. Deeply. Works on me immediately, but I have a faster metabolism. Effects won't appear in her case for a few days.
Why'd you choose this in the end?
Decided it was better than doing nothing.
I like you, Witcher. Here. A small gift. For giving a damn.
Thanks. So that was. And now let's proceed to look around your hut. Oh, you don't have anything lootable. Well, I did clear your garden already, so let's not worry about that too much. Let's go back to the village and see if the dwarf has any... Oh, and there's the hunter here. Okay, let's go see the hunter first. The venom extract. Cursed oil. I wonder, can I make any of these? That she gave me. Would need wolf's bane, but apart from that, yeah, I could. Cool. I guess we'll probably find wolf's bane somewhere. Of sweat and blood, what is that? Episcery entry 4. Okay. As I said, I'm not going to read the books in this playthrough because my throat is slightly damaged. Well, not really damaged, but... Well, I had a very bad cold recently, I did tell you about it, and it's... I can't speak for very long amounts of time at a time, and that makes my YouTubing quite difficult. Still, if I only talk normally, like I do now, and not read something aloud, and there is a big difference. I could police myself to read, you know, in a less strenuous way, but it is difficult. I think I lost. I think I lost the congruence of my speech here. What I'm intending to say is, if I'm reading something aloud, my voice gets strained much easier than if I'm just talking. And that would mean that if I read all those books to you, I could record 2 episodes instead of 4 in a sitting. And I think we would all prefer to have 4 recorded.
Anyone home? Must be out hunting.
All right, let's look. Also, can I steal your stuff in the meantime? Apparently not.
Trail's fresh. Mislav just left home.
Okay, what's that? Is that Wolfsbane? No, it's not Wolfsbane. Let's find Mislav. Yeah, I really like that there is an option to disable the fisheye effect of the Witcher senses. Hello, Mislav.
You, Mislav?
Shh! Hear that?
Wolves? No, wild dogs.
Yes, more dangerous than wolves.
Well, I know why. Yes, indeed, they are more dangerous than wolves, because wolves have common sense, pretty much. They know when to not approach someone.
Dogs more dangerous than wolves? Don't think so.
It's the truth. Know why?
No, but I guess you're about to tell me.
Wolves hunt to fill their bellies. Wild dogs kill for sport.
Just like humans.
Aye. They've learned much from us. Why not cruelty too?
Okay. Things are about to get pretty gruesome, so skip a minute ahead if you don't want to hear this story. But close to the place where I come from, not Geralt, me, Taureor, a few years back there was an incident when, in the winter, some wild dogs caught a guy in the woods and tore him to shreds because they were hungry. Didn't know him personally, but it does instill one with some caution. Okay, let's continue.
I'm hunting bigger game. The Nilfgaardians the Griffin killed. Where'd you find them?
Ah, I see. You a witcher. That monster slayer they's talking about in the village.
Mm-hmm.
I'll show you, sure. But I gotta kill those mutts before they hurt someone. Will you help? That is, if you don't mind blunting your silver blades on them.
Sure.
Sure. Griffin's not going anywhere.
No. Dogs might, though. So step careful now. Come on.
All right. This dog's been a problem for a while now.
Basic preparation.
Since the war started. Soldier on the march, he'll stop to rape a woman, strangle her, kill her man for a chuckle, even butcher a cow. But a dog, a kick in passing, no more. So these stray mutts form packs. They're gaunt, guts stuck to their spines, covered in scabies. But they're too late. Attacked another one.
Yeah, right. Right. All of them are quite... Oh, he was frozen by our runes. So that's quite interesting. They just get slower, right? Maybe I should have used the stun rune instead. Or the burning rune. Well, I did make my choice already. Raw meat. Yeah, wild dog meat is probably not the best thing to eat. But if you're a witcher, you're pretty much immune to anything, so...
Dieter.
You know him?
We served at the Lord's Manor together, where the Black Army's encamped now. He was a stable hand, I was the Lord's Hunter. But that was before... well, a long time ago.
Yeah, tell us.
Before what?
Before they drove me from the village.
What did you do?
Nothing. I'm a freak. Sorry. I'd rather not talk about it.
Well, yeah, I'm a freak too.
I'm a freak too.
Aye, but of another kind.
If it's lycanthropy, I can help.
What?
Lycanthropy. Werewolves. Handled a few cases in the past. It's usually a simple curse that...
The Lord's son, Florian, and I... we loved each other. Dieter walked in on us in the stables. They drove me away. Florian hanged himself. Lord started drinking, and the estate fell into ruin. That's the long and short of it.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Ancient history now. I was to show you where I found the Nilfgaardians. Come.
Yeah, sure.
Griffin, know anything about it?
Not much.
Search that.
Not my kind of game.
You're his kind, though. Survival instincts alone ought to make you care.
I walk silent through the woods. No griffin can hear me nor spy me.
Oh, well, good for you. Nice bow. Nice looking. Oh, we can sprint and he will sprint as well. Should have thought of it earlier. Come on, Ms. Love, show me.
Was here. One lay there, by the stump, headless. The other hung from a branch, guts splayed, stretching down to... Watch out for yourself now.
Nothing to mourn, they were they were people.
I'll be fine. Not the first griffin I've dealt with. Not likely to be the last, either.
Hope you're right. Good hunting now.
Okay, let's look around.
Ground's black, saturated with blood.
What else do we have here?
The guardians were celebrating. Griffin interrupted them.
In the middle of a road? It's weird.
A camp.
What else do we have here?
These prints are older and deeper, heavily armored. Elf guardians, probably.
Yeah, right, let's go after them. I can hear something. Is this a wolf? It's probably a wolf. Ooh, there's a chest down here. Yeah, let's go down there. Linen and some armor repair tools. Is there anything more out this way? There's usually some stuff in the canyons here. No, people fall down, lose their stuff. Oh, and there is a horse. Oh, was that the donkey that the griffin carried away earlier? Could have been. A cuckoo. And some wolver dogs, but let's follow the trail for now. Right. Still need to find that silver. I should... whoops, no, don't fall down. I need to talk to that... Oh, crap, no. Oh, good thing I got it, because... No, I will have to backtrack far. Is that wolfsbane there? We'll have to get back and check.
Griffin's nest. What remains of it, at least. Corpse is a couple of weeks old. Still alive when the griffin brought him here. Took a long time dying.
And that's a griffin here.
Bones. Horse. Dog. Human. A few months worth. Female. Larvae and her wounds have already hatched. Been dead at least a week. Either griffin must be a male.
Okay. Let's do
deep
one
cuts
one.
Over the whole body. Not a drop of blood on the beak or claws. Didn't defend herself. Crept up on her while she slept.
Well, it seems like there's human bones everywhere.
Gray hairs in the coat. 10, 12 years old. Griffins pair off for life when young. Male must be about the same age. Thick shaft, dense barbs. A royal griffin.
Okay, then.
Explains why the male I ran into was so aggressive. Hunted the Nilfgaardians down here in the forest first, then started prowling the area. Done all that way. Should talk to Vesemir.
Ooh, level 3. That was fast. I did this first, I might have found better gear. What do we have here? What do we have here? Crowns. Corons.
Burned. Only a human could do this.
Burn the nest, smash the eggs. Ooh! His Imperial Majesty Emervar Emrys. Let's see what sword we found. It's probably nowhere near as good as our current sword. Yeah, I can pretty much sell all of these. Okay. Let's go back to the village, but in the meantime, let's also have a look around the area. There might be some things we missed. Might be of interest. Oh, can I hear a place of... Yes.
Should draw from it.
Indeed you shall. Quen, no less. Actually, I have not dispensed with my newly gained character level. I can fill this slot. Don't have any mutagens, but... I guess I could get cut score techniques. Could get cut score techniques. Because I'm going to be wearing light armor mostly. I could also get some basic skills like this one, fast attack damage. Is it worth it? Is this each piece of light armor increases critical hit damage by 25% and fast attack damage by 5%. So for 4 pieces of armor, that's 100% critical damage increase and fast attack damage increase of 20%. Let's see if we're wearing all light armor. Light, 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 and light. I think that the Temerian armor we can purchase is also light. So let's buy that. Why is it here? Let's buy that skill. Cat school techniques. It's going to increase our damage quite a lot. Quintine intensity increased. Yes, we do need to invest in that sign too. Okay, there's something else in the area. Over here. Let us go. That's a tent. And a city in the distance.
How you like that silver?
Why are you talking about silver? It's deserters. Yeah, I forgot to put Quen up. Yeah, that new sword and that new skill do change quite a bit, don't they? That's not even dangerous. And we poisoned him. Oh, right, because that's a viper sword. Well, that was easy. Rusty sword, some dumplings. Well, you do love me some dumplings. Well, quite a lot of my audience is Polish, so you of course know pierogi, but do the rest of you know pierogi? It is traditionally a Polish dish, and actually, oh, I have an anecdote about that. When I talked to Quill at the Paradox event, that I went to. Silver, wonderful. We talked about food and, you know, cuisine from different countries. And he seemed surprised that pierogi, or pierogis, as you might know them, although it is pierogi, actually come in very, very many different types. Apparently the most known around the world is the one with cheese and potatoes. But actually, there's tens of types that you can find anywhere, every day. There's ones with meat, there's pierogi with fruit, with white cheese, other kinds of cheese, with mushrooms, salmon, and, well, even some vegetable ones like spinach. So, yeah, and they're amazing. And there's a wolf we might want to kill. Hello. Oh shit, shit, shit! No! What? Yeah, that is what happens when I start talking instead of focusing on the game. I do hope an autosave was made recently. I did? Well, kinda, yeah. Before I looted the camp. That is what happens every time I start talking about something other than the game, doesn't it? That should teach me, but it never does teach me. Alright, we've looted the place. Let's see, where are we going this time? Because I was just going somewhere. Oh, I could go back to the abandoned site here. No, let's do the lower level quests that we still have. Which a contract. Missing in action, find Dune, build a node. And collect Gwent cards. Let's do the contract for the Devil by the Well. The contract giver is over this way. Well, that seems like a job for Roach. Roach. Here you are. Good horsey.
Move it.
Yeah, move it, Roach. Why are you doing slacking off? And there are some wolves here. There are ones that killed me recently. Yeah, I need to be more cautious and never neglect Quen. And the dodging. Never neglect dodging as well. Yeah, you can hide the sword. Well, that was a nice coincidence. I didn't press the button, he just hit it on his own. At the very second I said it. Okay. Renaria. Didn't really have to purchase it. Okay, where's that contract giver? Oh, do you have some stuff to loot in your house? Maybe some silver? There's vinegar. Oh, you do! Wonderful! Silver ore! This is something that we actually did need. So we're going back to that Nilfgaardian soon. I need my silver sword made. You seem to not care that I loot your house.
Sleep. Sleep will lend you strength.
She's a fever. Has fainting spells. She's in a bad way, Master. A bad way.
Hello.
Greetings, good man. Having trouble with your well? That's what I read.
Aye. 'Tis haunted. Has been for a good 20 years.
20? So why'd you put out a notice just now?
Because earlier on we drew our water from the river. But so many corpses floating in it after the battle has turned noxious. My daughter Mandy drank half a pitcher. Felt dreadful ill, can't keep nothing down. She grows worse by the day. Herbalist claims you fight a fever with drink. And not beer nor cider, but water. Clear, pure water. And where am I to get that if not from the well? But first, the ghost's got to be driven away. And don't let any man near.
Tell me more.
This ghost. Describe it for me.
Well, it's awful frightening. Awful.
I meant, what does it look like?
It looks like a woman, but fresh from the grave. Wears a dirty dress, all rags, its skin flaking off its bones. And it howls like it's suffering.
Some wraith. Or maybe an alp.
If you don't wallop it, Master. If you don't take care of it, that is, it'll come kill me daughter.
I don't think I want to haggle with this man. I'll help him.
Fine, I'll help. Where's this well?
In Havel. A settlement on the heights. It's abandoned now. No one ventures there on account of the ghost being about. Drive it off. Please.
Alright, let's do that. Find the spirit that haunts the well. But first I need a new sword. And I don't feel like walking all the way back. So first let's talk to the merchants around here. See what price we can get for the gold rings that we have and for some other stuff. And then we'll go to the Nilfgaardian. But I think I'll use fast travel this time. Although there's still something on the way that we haven't explored.
A return customer. Welcome. What can I do for you this time?
Well, Willis, you can
show
trade
me what you
with
got.
Me. So, how much are you willing to give me for that ring? 48. That's the best we've gotten so far, I think. Well, I can sell you these. He's an armorer, right? 39 for the sword. I'm going to check if the Nilfgaardian will give me a better price for the swords. Because I might need to sell armor to the armorer and weapons to a weaponsmith. That might be wrong, though. I'm not sure. I'll keep those boots. Although, I'm going to be purchasing the Temerian ones, which are better. Okay, so this sword is 39 gold. Oh, not gold. It's, what, crowns? Novgorod crowns? I think so. Do you want to buy something else? Oh, do you have silver? Iron ingot? Steel ingot. No silver ingots. You do have some silver of this sword, but I do have enough silver, I think, now. We can dismantle pure silver into silver. Yeah, we'll be fine on the silver side of things. Have enough ore. So what was it again? 48. Let's go to the general goods merchant and to the tavern woman and see. 39 for the sword, let's remember that.
Freak.
We need to sell our stuff well, because money is scarce. Quite scarce. But we can always sell monster parts, which is quite useful.
By the wood, boy in Climax. Good lad, Master Witcher. Though he...
Yes,
this boy, will he venture out to inspect his grain any time soon?
What for? Harvest is a long way off yet.
Yeah, Vesemir, it is not time for the griffin yet. Let's not do anything like that. Hello,
woman. Something else you'll be needing.
Yeah, let's trade.
Got anything interesting under the counter?
Depends what you're after. Have a look.
Oh, a new card. What is this? Decoy. I do need more decoys. Let's buy that one. Okay, so do you want to buy the rings? 49. That's a pretty good price. That is a pretty good price. And how much for the bear hides? 41 for the bear hides and 49 for the rings. Let's compare that to the general merchant outside.
Farewell.
Yeah, we need to get a good price for our stuff. We did save his life, so he should be sympathetic. Hello, merchant.
Greetings.
Yes, let's trade.
Let me have a look at your stock.
Right. Yes, the Temerian armor, light armor. It's very good and also very expensive. But we do need it. First, let's see. How much are we paying for this? 26, not enough. How much are we paying for the gold ring? 30, not enough. And the bear hide, 27. Okay. I'm going to sell all this to the tavern woman. Oh, he buys drugs. Interesting. Let's go back to the tavern woman and sell her things.
Take care.
Not the swords, though. Not the swords. She doesn't buy them anyway. She also has a lot of money because I bought the Gwent cards from her. Hello, Elsa.
Something else would be neat.
Yeah, let's trade.
Got anything interesting?
Depends what you're after.
Yes, it depends what I am after. I'm going to sell you my gold rings. I'm going to sell you my expensive white wolf pelts and white bear pelts. And a deer hide. What else would you like? Would you like blunt axes? She wants everything. She likes us a lot. Old goat hide? I guess I could. Oh, wolf hides. Yes. Those will bring a pretty penny. And she's out of money. Well, that was a pretty good trade. Let's go to the Nilfgaardian's camp.
Farewell.
Might need to fast travel because that's quite a way off. I could explore those markers when I'm coming back. Need to compare my prices with this guy once more, because I forgot.
Poor, dark, and putrid.
Greetings.
So how much are you paying for a wolf pelt?
Let me have a look at your stock.
You're paying not enough. 26 for this. Willis paid 39. How much are you paying for a wolf pelt? 8. That is not very good, but it is something. Alright.
Take care.
Let's go and go to... Yeah, let's travel to the Nilfgaardian's camp. And on our way back, we'll check those two places. Oh, no, I didn't mean to attack you. Sorry. Clicked too many times. I need that serpentine sword crafted. Sorry. Move out of my way. I'm off my way. Hello, quartermaster. I'm here to haggle.
Show me weep.
How much are you going to give me for this sword? 40. He gives a better price than Willis. A slightly better price than Willis. I'm going to sell all my weapons to you. Well, apart from the one I'm using. So I don't really need that. It can be upgraded, but I'm not going to use this armor. I'm going to sell it to you. Oh, right. Crafting. I need that serpentine sword crafted. Viper steel sword. Needs emerald dust. Wait a minute. Oh, he has two to sell. I don't have emerald dust. I could maybe craft emerald dust. Do I have any emeralds to grind down? I might have to buy it, but the sword is superior to anything I have. It would be quite useful to have it. Let's look at the shop. You do have emerald dust, but it is prohibitively expensive. How much will you give me for those hides? You won't give me anything for those hides. That's pretty unfortunate. Do we have any emeralds? Oh, we do! So I can dismantle an emerald into emerald dust. That's better. That is much better. Okay, let's go to the crafting department. So what else do I require for the sword that I need? I need two silver ingots. Silver ingots. Let's make one. And for another, I would need one more silver ore. And can I make silver ore out of something? I could out of silver dust, or I could maybe dismantle pure silver. Oh, that's better. Yeah, let's do that. Okay. That did cost us quite a bit of money, but we're finally able to build, to craft the Viper steel sword, the Viper silver sword. Let's equip it and then sell the one we're using currently. We won't need this anymore. Yeah, equip that and put a rune in it. I guess I could use a burning one. Let's give it an option to cause burning. Good. Now, I'm going to sell this. And sell some other junk, because we need to have enough money to get all the Temerian armor. Yeah, let's
show me where you're peddling.
Trade a bit. You can have my silver sword. Although, what if I dismantled the silver sword? Silver ore and leather scraps, not worth it. We can have the silver sword. I could also sell you... I could sell you these boots, but they're pretty good. That's pretty much it. You could also get some monster tissue or stuff like that. With venom extract. Used to craft gear and items. Well, you can have a few. And that'll be it. Okay, so that's enough with the Nilfgaardians. Let's go and sell all our junk to the guy with the Temerian armor and pick up some Temerian armor. It's actually time to end the episode, but I'll at least finish my shopping before we do that. I could repair my armor, but as soon as we get to level 4, I will be... As soon as we get to level 4, I will be getting a new one, so it kind of defeats the purpose. Oh, I was supposed to check these areas too. Okay, let's fast travel to the mill. It's a bit closer. Also, I should check if I can actually open this chest, because I haven't really... Well, I did loot a lot, and... Okay, I'm trying to say a few things at once. First of all, there's the horse that we tamed. Still here. Weird. Seems like we can actually set the horses wherever we want them to be. Now, can I open this now? Locked. Key required. The key is somewhere. Don't know where yet. We'll find it. Might be in the first bandit camp that we hit. The first big one. Should I go back there and see? It was somewhere around here? Or here? Must have missed it. Okay, let's not worry about that. And go over this way. Yeah, even if we can't get it at just one lost chest. Hardly a big deal. If it's near the water, there's probably drowners. Drowners can kill us quickly, so let's be very, very cautious. Is there drowners here? Yes, of course there are. Hello, drowner. Okay, we can have a sword. Better and improved sword. Much improved. There's something down here. There's a drowner on the other side. Let's hope he doesn't see us, because he can kill us in the water. Okay, what do I... Locked! Key required! What's with the keys? Is there a body somewhere close? Might be a body somewhere. Oh, here's a body. Temerian Lily key. Oh, is it also for the other chest? Well, it removed the key when I use it. If it doesn't... Okay, silver amber necklace and some military orders. Right, I need to sell that blood-soaked military orders. Men bearing the missive are to be escorted north to the border post near Oxenfurt. Well, we do have... Oh, Temerian Volleyball's track quest. Yes, that is the same treasure. So now we have the key. We have found the crate through other means, because the spy told us where it was. But we didn't have the key. Now we have the key. So I wasted a lot of time trying to get to the chest. Still, now it should be available. Also, we have learned that selling weapons to armorsmiths is not such a bad idea, because they pay almost as well as weaponsmiths. Temerian Rye, Special Forces insignia, a longsword, and some documents. Scribbled documents. Let's read that. No wonder we're losing the war with cowardly cunts for soldiers. All it took were a few hours and a wallop of the mace for seasoning, and that was that. Battle was over. Okay. I'm not going to read everything. Come on, get out of here. Need to get back to the village, trade a bit, buy Temerian armor if we can, and go after the devil by the well. Also, there was one more thing I have not yet looted, and it is here. Hello, peasant. Hello, other peasant. Actually, I should probably call Roach, shouldn't I?
Run, Roach.
Yes, run, Roach. It'll be faster that way. Also, don't be too afraid of the drowners, please. They're just drowners. No, we... Stopping. Just gallop. Yeah, I can kind of take care of the drowners. Come on, Roach. Ooh, a place of power. Cool. And a wraith. Damn it. Am I gonna die? Oh, do I have wraith oil? Wait a minute, that's a weapon. It's probably worse than what I have. Yes, it is. I have spectre oil. And I have a better sword, and I have a burning sword. So we are in a much better situation than we were when we first fought a wraith. Much better. Maybe it's because it's level 6 and the previous one was level 7, but still. The difference is tremendous. Humongous, even. Emerald dust. Well. And I didn't have to... Well, I didn't really have to break down that emerald, then. Too late now. Then we gained a free ability point. Okay, let's see. Can we actually make a wraith decoction now? We are missing... Nostrix and Dwarven Spirits. Interesting. Yeah, I could do that. Let's get a roach. There is still this one place over here that we are to, you know, maybe kill one last monster or something like that. First, let's visit the herbalist, and I would actually like to make that decoction. We are missing Dwarven Spirit, but hopefully I can find it somewhere. Oh, more wolves. Forget the wolves. Don't get too scared of the wolves. Just go your way. And here's the herbalist's hut. has a dwarven spirit. If she does, I will buy it, because the decoction is pretty sweet. Yes. Hello, Tamira. No, no, I know what your story is.
Do I?
We must...
Let's skip that. Right.
Got any herbs you're willing to...
I'm sure I can find...
Merchandise. What do you have? She has dwarven... No, that's fifth essence. She does not have... She does have dwarven... 50 gold? I'm just going to buy one leaf of Nostrix. Seems like it might be difficult to obtain. And I'm going to hope I find dwarven spirit elsewhere. That'll make the decoction. Is there anything else I could do? Cursed oil. Yeah, let's get some wolfsbane from her. Do you have wolfsbane? What did that look like? Is this wolfsbane? Buy some grass. This is wolfsbane, isn't it? Yes. Get one of these. Do you want to buy some... fruit? No. No. Oh, you want to buy some wolf liver? Not really. She would buy... drowner stuff and ghoul stuff. We need to hunt more drowners and ghouls for ingredients. Oh, and you would buy the silver necklace. 87. 87. I think the general merchant will give me a better price. But let's remember her price. 87. Okay, it's time to get to the village. Am I going the right way? Of course I am. Yeah, let's finish the shopping in this episode. I know it's super long, but I want to finish the shopping and get on with fighting in the next one. If you want to stop watching now, feel free. I'll just be doing the shopping. Oh, goats. Cool. Do you have anything to loot? Yes, quite a lot of it, actually. Rotting flesh in a chest in the bedroom. I know it's randomly generated, but seriously, rotting flesh. What? What do you want?
A wild hunt in the heavens, always.
I was just running across the field. What do you want? Oh, maybe I trampled some of her crops or something. Oh, someone stepped in a poo-poo. I forgot what the price was. Was it 90-something? Something around that.
Return customer.
Yes, Willis. What you will give me for the necklace? I'm certainly going to sell you a sword, but how much will you, are you willing to give me for a necklace? 101. Okay, that's a good price. Better than one that she did.
So long.
And now the general merchant. I would trade with the innkeeper, but I did use up all her gold, and she doesn't have anything I want to buy. And he does. Hello, general merchant, sir. Let's see what you have. So, how much for the necklace? 63, that's a shit price. At least you'll buy those worn pelts and stuff like that. Here, have some worn pelts. You could sell dumplings, but who would sell dumplings? Bear hide, sure. Wolf hides, yes. Goat hides. Chains, sure. Rabbit pelts, yes. If I'm missing leather later on... Sure, you can have some rotting flesh as well. A black magic doll and a human skull. What have all this junk? Oh, you buy drugs. Sure, have the drugs as well. Tamarian Special Forces insignia. I'm not sure if this is useful for any quests, so let's hold on to this. Does not have enough coin. Oh, right, I used up all your coin. I love those saddlebags. But it's likely I'll get better ones later. The armor is top priority. So pretty expensive, isn't it? Well, we certainly need it. So you don't need those shoes. Armor is 14 and this is 15, so I can sell that. Willis would be giving me a better price, though. Okay, this costs 485. I don't have that kind of money, but when I deal with the ghost, I should. Here, have a candelabrum or some fistek. Vial. Sure, have the vials as well. And all the fishing gear you can take, and the rope ladders. I don't need to be carrying this around. Oh, and you want to buy all this other junk as well. You want timber. Monster liver. Well, if I'm selling this to anyone, I should be selling this to the herbalist. Okay, for now, let's be satisfied with what we have. And then I'll buy the rest later on. Okay, so that's all the shopping for now.
Take care.
I will need this armor. I will be using it as soon as we get to level 4. And that's it for this episode. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. And next episode, we're going to fulfill some quests, some witcher contracts, kill some monsters, and all that. Goodbye.